Hello, good morning. Now, this received my beer order from New Bristol Brewery, which is in preparation for tonight's beers. All the beers delivered today will be all the way from Bristol in the UK. But yeah, so here's the six beers I bought this time by a start. Cinder. Stout. I've got the Imperial version. Now this is the beer that we'll be drinking tonight with two other Bristol breweries. This is the Creme Brûlée Stout, weighing at 7%. Oh, it's fluff on the lid. Forward to this one, beautiful artwork. This box was part inspired for this beer. So I had a profit for a while, just lockdown as such. And you best all been 18 out of the park. As before, stand a vanilla. It's like, they've all got like musical names from. And this is phenomenal. At this last weekend, another beer. But yes. Be having this later. Creme Brûlée Stout. The other two breweries are Great Western and Newtown. Park. I think that's right. But yeah. I would have got more of these, but I wanted to try the new ones that all the beers I had before from Bristol. But yes, tonight, Bristol Breweries, Great Western, New Bristol, and Newton Park. Yep, here they are. Mr. Macchiato Coffee Stout from the Great Western Brewing Company, 6%. Got introduced with Macchiato's when I went to Sardinia. The family. Newtown Park, brand new brewery to me. Their internal Monologue Stout 5.4, a perfect beer for a Sunday on the sofa. But yeah, looking forward to those two brand new breweries to me, as well as the Creme Brûlée. Finally, see it's worked for me. Now I've just got to wait for the train to get back to us. Yay! Looking forward to some beers from Bristol. On my way home. Right, it's my destination. So, looking forward to drinking the Great Western, the Newtown Park, and the New Bristol Brewery. Yes! Very soon.
Ew, I've waited all day for these! So, let's crack them open. All from Bristol. Yep. Only one bottle, so let's get that open first. I paid £2.99 for this. Obviously, from Great Western Brewing, and it's the Mr. Macchiato Coffee Stout. Basically, a bear in a wood. In woods, wearing a tie, drinking coffee. Actually, when I was in Alaska, That's on my last day, I saw a family of bears just walking down the road, as they do. I purchased the Great Western via bottles and books, just like I purchased this beer. Newtown Park Brewing Internal Monologue Stout, 5.4%. So I've been having a lot of new Bristol beers. Speaking of such, another stout from New Bristol. All these are stouts, all in the own different way. The Newtown Park is a traditional stout. The Great Western is a coffee stout, and this one is a Creme Brûlée stout. So, so I've been buying all these six packs from New Bristol Brewery, and you know, I thought, you know what, I'm gonna try some Bristol beers. So I purchased some via bottles and books, and yeah, they've been good. Great selection on the website. I'll put some airplane mod. On the website there's great selection on bottles and books, all ranging from all different styles of beer, but I chose 12 stouts, and these are two. So I've had Newtown Park before, and I've had Great Western Brewery before. Just a simple kind of Windows player kind of stream, peel off can. Yep. So nice clean crisp artwork on the can, nice profile, and then nice list of information below on the back. Also, so this has got a hint of coffee. It doesn't mean it actually has coffee, but a lot of stouts have hints of coffee and chocolate. But yeah, we're long day. We're waiting all day for these. Oh, it smells good. So it was at 5.4%. It's internal monologue. Nice artwork on the top logoing. But yeah. You do get coffee and chocolate. Cheers. Right. Nice traditional stout. I had really lovely stouts the other night. So I'm looking forward to trying this coffee stout. Okay, nice chocolate tones and coffee tones. Not in your face, but basically just simple, well managed, balanced beer. Nice beer. First time we need to pack. I've got this because I like coffee stouts, I like stouts, and I like bears ever since I came up from Alaska. You know, I just all my friends were in Alaska were like, you haven't seen your bear, we've all seen bears this week, and you haven't seen a bear. And then my friend took me up to the flat tops in Alaska. Big long road, steep. We got to the top. Beautiful view. Alaska was a beautiful trip. Some amazing people. Well, yes, on the way down, basically just there. Like out the three bears kind of thing. Just basically Big Mama Bear and then the teenager bear and such and such. So they're just casually walking down, and friend says, sure, we're finally going to see some bears. So we slow down, stop, and they're like, wow, real wildlife bears. And then friend says, she took a picture. I'm like, all right, cool, yeah, let's go, yeah. Let's think about that. So I went over the door. She's like, if I keep a cab, I will kill you. And lo and behold, it didn't kill me. I basically climbed up onto looked in the car like that, at the back window. And I just fetched on the bears. And mum and bear were just like from a distance. So I'm like, there's a big bear. But yeah, that's pretty cool. That's how it works. But yeah, let's look. This is the font is a bit tiny. I think magnifying glass. That'd be it. So this weighs in at 6%. I can't remember if that was that or that, because I've basically lost in the story. So, lightish brown head, off-white, medium carbonation. You can see something straight, it's like a reddish dark brown. Hints of, now, I've got the information actually. I did it earlier. Because I know as soon as it gets this energy saver light bulb. So I looked up the information earlier. And I think when I looked it up, a macchiato is basically foam, milk, and coffee. Is that one? No, that's what I had last night. There it is. So this coffee stout has lightly roasted malts that give a subtle taste, allowing coffee to shine through. Coffee malty. So it doesn't really say if it has coffee in it. Because the writing is too small to me to read. In the slightest. Well, anyway. It is tasting a little more coffee than the previous one, the Newtown pack. And it is really palatable. It's not as coffee forward as the one I had last night from Basement Beer. The Lost Horizon, that was good. But in fairness, this is a very quaffable beer. 6%. Why do it so tiny? I expect people to read it. Let's get me torch out. But yeah, the selection on the if a bear could drink coffee, he would drink it out of a wooden mug. Out of a wooden mug. And from of a mountainous backdrop, probably made with environmentally friendly decaf coffee. Coffee has been decaffeinated with the Swiss water process, which uses no chemicals. Lightly roasted malts give us a little taste, allowing the coffee. Ah, so it actually does have coffee in it. Actually, in the ingredients, it does say coffee. So, I don't know if there's any special process that they used, but it's okay. It's not really coffee forward, but $2.99, that's a very tasty beer. Now here's the one I've been waiting for all day. I've done my beer ticking, two brand new breweries. Now, here we go, Cremé Brûlée. Now, that Irish cream, so Moorish. It has this elements of these. Now I just watched Beard Meets Beer on the work. He reviewed the banana stout from New Bristol, which I missed out on. But now he's an IPA guy, and he loved it. And he had the salty cinder toffee. Oh, that's exceptional imperial stout. Which I purchased again, and the ice cream I purchased again. The cinder toffee, the session cinder toffee stout, I purchased that again. Very nice. Even New Bristol making some solid beers, but the website alternates all the time, so there's never the same beers on. So you got to like follow it every week. Such good beers on there. So this weighs in at 7%. Now I almost added this because I'm going to do two vanilla imperial stouts. I almost added to that selection, but you know what? They're like 10%, and this is like 7%. So it won't be fair. But this is such a nice beer. It's rare nowadays to have a beer brewery that does solid IPAs, solid stouts. It's either one or the other. But they seem to be like either bunting it or hitting it out of the park. And the stouts are hitting it out of the park. This is a beautiful beer. All three have been good, and it's great to celebrate Bristol beers, because as much as I wanted to visit Bristol twice last year, but pandemic, I get to have Bristol beers right here in my home, shared by all the memories behind me. Oh, smells good. And it has the elements of the cinder toffee in there. But the balance in it is beautiful. Creamy, texture's lovely. Vanilla custard, creme brulee, coffee, and so the both coffee elements to them. Almond, malts, or blood-touched brown. See, again, it mentions the blood-touched. They must just walk around. Bristol must walk around with their blood-touched. They're like, what can we blood-touch next? was brewed in the making of the luscious milk stout. So they must have a base milk stout and an alternate with different things. Taste creme brulee Evan. Ops East Cake Goldens. But yeah, again, exceptional artwork from New Bristol. These are almost like, I remember back in the early days when I started getting, there was a brewery in Bradford called Salamander. The pump clips were a collector's item because every one was handmade, and obviously each one was a limited edition. I can just see that New Bristol labels just being the same kind of thing, just limited edition labels, because basically each one has got its own label. Each one is a tribute to the beer and a tribute to the artist. I think it's Tom Moore that does the artwork. I think someone mentioned it. But just these three beers alone, just and the dedication of bottles and books, inspired me wanting to visit Bristol again. I know some of the beer tubers are visiting after the pandemic, but it is what it is. We'll all wait for the full clear. But Great Western Brewery, solid session beer, and affordable, $2.99, that's quality beer, that price. Definitely buy more from the Great Western Brewery. Newton Park, nice, solid, traditional stout. Easy drinking, and the New Bristol, well, you know, I've said it in all my videos. a solid brewery. Anyway, check out Bottles and Books, check out New Bristol Brewery, check out Great Western Brewery, check out Newtown Park, and check out Beer That Makes Beers. Without him, I wouldn't have tried New Bristol, and it wouldn't have led on to other things and such. And Aaron Meadows, who from Blue Nose Beer Reviews, he recommended Bottles and Books. Until next time, you take care. Goodbye.